Hello, Retinal 100 here, and welcome to our new adventure. Let's play the Stanley Parable. How about we get started right away, because I'm excited, I really want to play this game. Let's go. The end is never. Well, I hope there is an end. If there's not, it has not so much of a meaning. Okay, this might take a while. Alright, we're nearly here. And yes. No,
this
I don't
want to. This is the story of a man named
Skip.
Stanley.
Okay.
Stanley worked for a company in a big building where he was employee number 427. Employee number 427's job was simple.
Well, this
he sat
is
at
going
his
to be
desk
important.
In room 427, and he pushed buttons on a keyboard. Orders came to him through a monitor on his desk, telling him what buttons to push, how long to push them, and in what order. This is what employee 427 did every day of every month of every year. And although others might have considered it soul-bending, Stanley relished every moment that the orders came in.
I'm alone.
Though he had been made exactly for this job.
My own heaven or hell.
Stanley.
In the void.
And then one day, something very peculiar happened. Something that would forever change Stanley. Something he would never quite forget. He had been at his desk for nearly an hour when he realized that not one single order had arrived on the monitor for him to follow. No one had showed up to give him instructions, call a meeting, or even say hi.
Rude motherfuckers.
Never in all his years at the company had this happened. This complete isolation. Something was very clearly wrong. Shocked, frozen solid, Stanley found himself unable to move for the longest time.
Please let
but
me
as
move.
He came to his wits and regained his senses, he got up from his desk and stepped out of his office.
Don't tell me what to do. Okay. Well, that was a nice... Yeah, that looks a bit disgusting. Good. That was a nice little intro to the game. So, let's see. Can I click anything? Nope. Oh, I'm stuck. Okay, thank you. How did I get stuck? Okay. That's weird, I randomly get stuck right there. Like, what even? Okay, so... Employee 427. Alright! For those that don't know me too well, I'm kind of... Is it actually ticking? Yeah, it is. Wow. I kind of have the... need to look at... random shit and click stuff, so this will take a while. Nope, that's close.
All of his co-workers were gone. What could it mean?
Somebody closed
Stanley
my door.
Decided to go to the meeting room. Perhaps he had simply missed a memo.
I wanna know what I want a purple mug. Alright, so does it say I hate Mondays? Most likely.
No matter how hard Stanley looked, he couldn't find a trace of his co-workers.
Thank you for the audio glitches. Oh, click. Beep beep. That's great. My PC does not want to cooperate. So yeah. How's everyone doing? I hope you all had a good and not too eventful, but kind of eventful Christmas. I'm pretty sure this is going to go up after New Year's, so I hope you had a fucking fantastic...
Stanley went around touching every little thing in the office, but it didn't make a single difference, nor did it advance the story in any way.
Okay, listen here, bitch. Don't interrupt me. Where was I? Right. I hope you all had a fucking brilliant...
Stanley clicked on literally every single door in the office because he doesn't pick up well on cues from his environment.
Listen here, alright? F- Fuck off. I'm talking. Okay. Click. What I wanted to say is, I hope you had a fucking good New Year's. And drank quite a lot. And holy shit. Stop fucking up on me. Close the door. I don't like you. Nope. Nope. Okay. Oh, there's one. Nope. Two lonely mugs. Can I go? No, of course not. Eek.
When Stanley came to a set of two open doors, he entered the door on his left.
No, he didn't. Because you have been interrupting me all the time, I'm going right. Fuck you, mate.
This was not the correct way to the meeting room, and Stanley knew it perfectly well. Perhaps
yeah,
he wanted to stop by the employee lounge first, just to admire it.
Oh, okay. How about I get some coffee or a cup of tea? That would be great. Oh, thank you. Oof, I apologize for the random lagging and glitching, because I'm pretty sure it's my PC.
Truly a room worth admiring. Oh. It had really been worth the detour after all.
Yeah,
just
it's
to spend
blue.
A few moments here in this immaculate, beautifully constructed room.
Mm-hmm, that's
Stanley
beautiful.
Simply stood here, drinking it all in.
I'm not standing, I'm looking. 125 for a drink. That's a lot.
Yes.
Really
worth
it. Oh,
really
I got a new achievement. I can't jump.
A room so utterly captivating.
Shut
but
up.
Eager to get back to business, Stanley took the first open door on his left.
No. You've been an asshole. Now I'm going to be a prick.
Stanley was so bad at following directions, it's incredible he wasn't 5 years ago.
That's true. Oh, hey. Caution, do not lie. If you're lying right now, stop. I'm not lying, I'm just reading fucking... Can I? No. Just reading something. What's that? Do not jump from the cargo. Left while in motion. Will cause death. Yeah, I suppose so. Penalty for misuse of cargo lift. $1,000! Holy shit, that's expensive. Penalty for jumping off the cargo lift. 5,000. And if I just jump down from here, would I have to pay money too, or is that fine? Oh hey, there's a door over there. And there. And there. I just use the fucking lift.
Look, Stanley, I think perhaps we've gotten off on the wrong foot here.
Oh hey, more doors.
Really, I'm not. I realize that investing in your trust in someone else can be difficult, but the fact is that the story has been about nothing but you.
Ooh.
Or what? Really? I was in the middle of something. Do you have zero consideration for others?
Yeah, kinda.
Are you that convinced that I want something bad to happen to you?
Not particularly.
I don't know how to convince you of this, but I really do want to help you, to show you something beautiful.
That's debatable.
Let me prove it. Let me prove that I'm on your side. Give me a chance.
Alright. Maybe. Danger everywhere. Yeah, that's about it. That's kinda accurate. Oh, what's that? Nothing. Okay. 2B1. Nope. Doesn't wanna. 2B3. Nope. 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 Oh.
Now
don't
listen carefully,
again?
This
yeah.
is important.
Alright.
Stanley walked through the red door.
There's a white one. With the light not working? Or is that... I don't know. Looks like a light. Nope! Need a key card. Don't have a key card. Am I ever going to get a key card? Let's go. Hello?
Aha! Perhaps you misunderstood.
You fucking
Stanley
teleported me.
Through the red door.
You little bitch! Don't teleport me. Don't do it. Blue. Even though I love the fucking color red.
I still don't think we're communicating properly.
Stop
Stanley
it.
Stanley walked through the red door.
Dude, I heard you the first time. I just don't give a fuck. Oh, hey, there's the blue door.
All right, fine. Go ahead, Stanley.
Thank you.
You want to know so badly what's out there? You
yeah.
want to find out what lies at the end of this road you've chosen? Well, don't let me stop you.
All right. Hope everyone is having a smashing time. I'm having fun. Exploring!
You see,
oh, this is really fucking orange.
I haven't even finished building this section of the map, because you were never supposed to be here in the first place.
Then why even
broken
build it?
Rooms, exposed developer textures.
If I was never supposed to see it, then why is there even
was
a room here?
Was it worth ruining the entire story I had written out specifically for you? Do you not think I put a lot of time into
Don't
that?
Don't be rude.
Because I did. And in the end, it was all
What's
for nothing.
There?
Because this is
What's
what you wanted to see. Help me here, Stanley. Help elucidate these strange and unknowable desires of yours.
Oh, what that's gonna take a while.
Better? What did you want to see? Vehicles?
No.
Skill trees?
No.
Work with me. You've given me absolutely nothing so far.
Absolutely nothing.
I'll tell you what. Let me take a stab in the dark at a new design and you can
All
give
right.
me some feedback.
Stab the dark for me.
There we go. A third option. This already feels leaps ahead of where we were before. Go ahead, Stanley. Take it for a spin.
You know that I'm not going to go there right now because I'm an asshole. So how about I go that way? I'm just a prick, I know it. 128, 128. Okay. Bing.
Okay, I'm going to stop you there. Now, tell me about your experience with this new version. Would you say that the game benefited from allowing you more choices? Feel free
Love
to
it.
Be honest. I'm
Love
looking
it.
For some real critical feedback here.
I don't know. Three? In the middle?
Oh, of course.
Mediocre.
Three. Really? Maybe
yes.
next time we can get you to form an actual opinion? You
Maybe.
Know? Any level of critical thinking or engagement with your surroundings? Does that sound good?
What,
Think we
what
can do
surroundings
that?
Don't
yes?
do? Man.
Wonderful.
No surroundings here.
Here, based on the data from your previous playthrough,
Which
I've compiled...
Which previous playthrough?
Perfectly candid, I think I've knocked it out of the park with this one.
All let's right, let's see it. What the fuck is that? The Stanley Parable, what? What? Worldwide leaderboard. Oh shit, what? That's... A lot of doors. Okay. And endings. Fuck. Okay, shit, that's... A dead rat. Stanley. What? Objectively ranked. Objectively. Why not us? Francis empty. Oh, you bitch. It's not empty. It's offline. Bye. I'm gonna go this one. Bitch.
Now, would you say that competitive leaderboard helped you feel motivated to keep walking through doors?
No.
Again, honest answers, please.
Oh, you little bitch. Fuck your leaderboard.
Hey, I nearly forgot. I've got a prototype of a new game I've been
Yay!
Working on, and now would be a
Yay.
Lovely opportunity to give it some playtesting.
Okay.
You wouldn't mind taking a look at it, would you? Perfect.
I have time.
Let me boot it up.
Yay! Oh, please don't take forever. Okay. Did that go backwards for a second?
In this game, the baby crawls left towards danger.
Okay.
You click the button to move him back to the right, and if he reaches the fire, you fail.
Okay.
It's a very meaningful game. All about the desperation and tedium of endlessly confronting the demands of family life.
Confronting the demands of family life.
Really take notice. But of
course, that's good for
the
holidays, isn't it?
Only
kind of accurate.
Once you've been playing it for about 4 hours. So why don't you give it 4 hours of play to make sure it's effective? Be sure to keep notes on your experience.
I really couldn't give a toss about that baby. Goodbye.
Heartless bastard. Did you do it because you hate babies or purely to spite me? Because
Both?
If it's the latter, well, I don't know what to do. I'm completely out of ideas. I can't think of a single thing that might improve the experience for me. I'm not even going to try. I'm out.
Aw, come back, baby.
Thank you for playing. Your input was extremely valuable. Oh, hey, since
come
my
back,
game
baby.
Was so awful, why don't we play someone else's game? Just
what
to
game?
Ease the pain. Let's see.
I'm having quite a lot of fun. Okay.
Yes. This seems like it'll work. Let's give it a shot.
Oh, thank you. Loading. Again.